Just before we get started, I do want to mention another channel that I host called Mega Projects. Mega Projects is a channel all about mankind's greatest achievements, where I take a deep look at incredible buildings, projects, structures, and more. Whether it's the world's most impressive skyscrapers, the International Space Station, or Chernobyl's sarcophagus, I cover it all. New videos come out a couple of times a week on Mega Projects, so if you think it could be for you, please do head over and subscribe. There is a link below, and let's get into it. With the incredible diversity of life found on Earth today, it is easy to forget that all of it is one big coincidence. Most of us imagine the path to evolution to be straightforward, though it's anything but. Many random yet pivotal events had to happen at the right time in our collective history to make way for the countless life forms that we see around us today. Without any of those events, the natural landscape of the planet would be very different from what it is today. Number 8. The last universal common ancestor. Even if there are virtually countless forms of life on Earth today, every one of them shares a single common ancestor. We know this with certainty due to commonalities found in all three of the major branches of life. Bacteria, archaea, and eukaryotes, which includes all animals, plants, and fungi, though we're still far from knowing exactly what that creature was. Traditional evolutionary wisdom says that this organism, known as the last universal common ancestor, couldn't have been more complex than the simple microbes found on Earth today. According to some recent research, though, the LUCA was likely to have been far more complex than we previously thought, even more so than some microbes we know of today. One probable explanation is that they initially started out as more complex beings, though lost some of those complexities on the way in order to adapt to their environments as they branched into their own species. Number 7. The Cambrian Explosion. It's difficult to imagine right now, but complex multicellular life is a rather recent phenomenon in the Earth's history. For the most part, life existed as simple, single-celled organisms bearing little to no resemblance to any life form today. Most of them couldn't move and didn't even require oxygen to survive, and could best be described as barely alive blobs of living material. That was the case for billions of years after life first emerged on the planet, though it all changed with a massive and mysterious event around 540 million years ago. Known as the Cambrian Explosion, this was when complex multicellular creatures exploded in population across the oceans, though we still don't know the precise circumstances that led up to it. The fossils from before that time are conspicuously devoid of any complex life, though something happened around 540 million years ago that caused life to leave its single-celled kind of pathetic existence and transform into the slew of oxygen-based complex creatures that we see around us today. While we may never know what happened around that time for sure, as archaeological evidence from then remains scarce and unreliable, studies suggest that the Cambrian explosion may have coincided with the sudden rise in oxygen levels in the oceans at the time. Number 6. Sexual reproduction. The evolution of sexual reproduction may sound like an obvious step for any evolving species because sex is great, though its evolutionary benefits aren't that immediately apparent. Sexual reproduction comes with the inherent cost of the males. Asexual organisms can reliably pass on double the number of genes than sexual ones, as males, approximately one half of the species, do not reproduce. Science has never been able to come up with why we would develop sex at all, as no number of benefits seem to offset the massive cost to the species. Regardless of its mysterious origins, sex remains one of the most important traits that life has developed in the course of its evolution. Sex has played an irreplaceable role in shaping up the world through natural selection, possibly driving the evolution of most complex animals that we see around us, including us. While we can't say that life would never have evolved to this extent without sex, as asexual beings are perfectly capable of complex evolution, it sure would have looked a lot different than it does now. Number 5. The Great Leap Forward. The last 100,000 years or so have been particularly eventful for the human species, so much so that we forget that for large chunks of our history, absolutely nothing of note was happening. While ancestors of modern humans have existed for over 2 million years, for about 90% of that time, there were no noticeable innovations in toolmaking, art, or language. This was the time other human species competed for resources with our Homo sapien ancestors, including the Neanderthals. Then, about 60,000 years ago, something changed. Known as the Great Leap Forward, this when we suddenly, but rapidly, started developing new tools, languages, systems of political organization, and art, marking one of the most important points in the course of our evolution. As this was also when we first moved out of Africa to populate Eurasia, some scientists believe that the Great Leap Forward was a result of a widespread drought in Africa, which forced us to look for greener pastures elsewhere. It's plausible, as we know for a fact, that Earth was going through a massive ice age around this time. Number 4. The Great Dying. It's not breaking news that the Earth's landscape was once dominated by dinosaurs and reptiles. The oceans were filled with even more types of humongous and dangerous creatures, making the whole planet a thriving, if a bit deadly, place. Come to think of it, the conditions at that time don't sound conducive for any species other than even large reptiles or even larger marine animals, let alone mammals, a relatively harmless branch of life compared to those bear moths. So how did we ever survive that? The answer is the mass extinction, perhaps the biggest one ever, colloquially known as the Great Dying, which happened at the end of the Permian period, around 252 million years ago. The mass extinction still don't know much about, killed off over 90% and 70% of all marine and land species respectively. While it was definitely a sad event for the life forms on Earth before that, it was what we needed to evolve. Fortunately for us all, the immediate ancestors of all mammals, cynodonts, were one of the few species that survived the extinction, inheriting a largely lifeless and empty surface full of opportunities. The earliest mammals were small and had little existential threat from the giant predators of before. As a result, they were able to grow and evolve into all the diverse mammal species that we see around us today, including humans. The Great Dying is the reason mammals rule over the Earth's surface today instead of flying reptiles. Number 3. The emergence of eukaryotes. The term eukaryote may not mean much to most of us, but for an evolutionary biologist, it is one of the most important chapters in the story of life on Earth. Just like the last common ancestor was a drastic divergence from life forms that came before it, eukaryotes were a crucial divergence from the two main other branches of life, bacteria and archaea. Eukaryotes, one of the three major branches of life, which includes animals, plants, and all other major types of life that we see around us, are fundamentally different from bacteria and archaea in every way, right from the cellular level. It was an important transition that made many complex functions of our body possible, even if we still don't know the precise conditions that led to it. Number 2. When flowers took over the world. Whenever we talk about the biggest factors that contributed to the evolution of life on Earth, we often forget about plants. It's no exaggeration to say that without the huge variety of plants on Earth, each with their own unique role in maintaining the ecosystem, life as we know it wouldn't exist. What most of us don't know, though, is that the types of flora we see on Earth today are very different from most of history. Ferns and cone-producing conifers, not flowering plants, ruled the Earth for the most part. Then, about 130 million years ago, flowering plants came out of nowhere and rapidly invaded all but the most inhospitable places on the planet. As a result, flowering plants outnumber ferns and conifers by 20 to 1 today. The importance of flowering plants as a crucial step for life on Earth can't be overstated. Apart from keeping livable ecosystems balanced, flowering plants also provide animals with a source of food and nutrition, without which any evolution, at least for the larger animals, would have been impossible. Number 1. The Great Oxidation Event. You'd be surprised to know that for about half of Earth's history, its atmosphere was almost entirely devoid of oxygen. It wasn't always an oxygen-rich world waiting for oxygen-based organisms to come along and inhabit it. In fact, there's a good chance that may never have happened at all, if not for something that occurred around 2.4 billion years ago. Called the Great Oxidation Event, it was by far the most important event for life on Earth, as well as one of the most mysterious. Around that time, something pumped the Earth's atmosphere with huge amounts of oxygen, setting the stage for every major development in the course of our evolution. Some scientists suspect a kind of bacteria, cyanobacteria, that releases oxygen as a byproduct, which may have contributed to the rising oxygen levels at that time. Whatever its origins, the Great Oxidation Event was the single most pivotal point for life on Earth, as without oxygen, most of the life forms found on Earth today simply wouldn't exist. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below, and don't forget to subscribe. We got brand new videos every day of the week, and as always, thank you for watching.